Hey folks, welcome back to Let's Play Grand Theft Auto Vice City on the Mysterious JG. So there's a couple of different missions in this game, side missions. They're pretty much abandoned in the most recent Grand Theft Auto games, but Grand Theft Auto 3, Vice City, and San Andreas had ambulance missions, firefighter missions, and vigilante missions. Vice City also had Pizza Boy missions. Can't remember if San Andreas had Pizza Boy missions. It had some various goofy missions. Liberty City Stories and Vice City Stories. I never played Vice City Stories. I played a little bit of Liberty City Stories. Those games had, I think, the three main missions, Ambulance, Firefighter, and Vigilante 2. Ambulance missions, you got to rescue people. And with every level of mission, it's you saw fire truck missions, right? We're trying to put out fires. As you put one out, a new one immediately spawns, and there's a constant countdown clock, and you get more time as you complete each level, but it gets harder and harder. And I didn't on-screen manage to get to level 12. I did that eventually. I did that. I don't remember if it was 3 or Vice City. Vice City I did pretty close to 100% run back in the day on original hardware. I really enjoyed the game. But, yeah, you saw me doing all the firefighter missions I think I'm going to do on-screen. And you saw how it works. You know, if I kept practicing, I could get better. If you're interested in this game on PS4 or whatever, you could play it for yourself and see if you could do better. It's all good. Rescue missions are very similar. You get an ambulance, and there are accident sites, and you get there, and you try to rescue the people. They're not, like, running around trying to escape, which makes it easier than firefighter missions. But the ambulance is extremely easy to roll, and you have to, every time you rescue people, you can hold so many injured people in your ambulance at a time, and you got to take them to the hospital. So it's like constantly running back and forth between hospital and accident sites where people are hurt, and then obviously as you get up to level 9, 10, 11, 12, you have like tons of people who need to be rescued, and you can only hold two or three at a time, so you got to go pick one up, drop them to the hospital, pick them up, drop them to the hospital. You got to plan your routes. But if you get level 12 firefighter missions accomplished, you become fireproof. If you get level 12 ambulance Hunter or ambulance missions in this game, you get infinite run. In Grand Theft Auto 3, that's how you get 150 as your max health instead of 100. In this game, you do pizza delivery missions, which are kind of similar to ambulance missions. You can only carry so many pizzas at a time. The pizzas are generic. Different people don't order different things. But you have to ride to where somebody is waiting for a pizza and throw it to them using the actual same mechanics you would use to do a drive-by. You throw them a pizza. And on maps where there's more than six people, which starts to happen around level 6 or 7, you have to go back and get more pizzas during it. And it gets into this whole thing of planning your routes and like, okay, I can deliver six pizzas. There's three people clustered here. There's three people clustered there. Here there's three and there's four. I can't get them all in one trip. Blah, blah, blah. There's strategy involved there. We'll try pizza missions on screen so you can see it. And if you get level 12, you get extra health. The last of these, at least as I'm describing them, are the vigilante missions. And that's where you actually, the things that spawn, and it's the same, like pizza missions, like you have a countdown timer and you get more time as you complete a full level of mission, not for each pizza to deliver, but as you complete level 1, level 2, level 3. Same thing for the ambulance missions. Level 1, level 2, level 3, you get more time. Vigilante missions are the same, except that what's spawning are cars with criminals in them, and you have to kill the criminals. And you have to be in a law enforcement vehicle to do it. So people traditionally find this easier, because if you do it in a police car, it's kind of tricky because people will fire back at you. Also, as you're going around shooting people, you get a wanted level. So pretty soon, you're in a cop car, but other cop cars are on the map trying to stop you. In a Rhino, I'll try it on screen with the Rhino at least once, but the problem with the Rhino is it's slow. You run out of time. And in a Rhino, you can be jacked. Like the cops are not going to be able to kill you while you're in a Rhino, but they can arrest you by just like, you know, the same way you would jack a car in this game by walking up to the door and hitting the triangle button when it's not moving or when it's moving slowly, police can jack you out of a car and arrest you. And, like, you're arrested instantly. Like, as you get thrown onto the ground and they point a gun at you. You don't get a chance to get up and fight them. So the Rhino is pretty ridiculously easy to get arrested in. It's very difficult for them to kill you. It's easy for them to arrest you. Because, as stupid as this sounds, they just walk up to it and pull you out of it the same way they would pull you out of any other car. And the Rhino is slow to accelerate. So you'll see that. But the Hunter, it's just a matter of... it's the helicopter controls are tricky. But if you can figure them out, nothing can stop you. So let's see. Well, I mean, you can get stuck on the side of it, I suppose, Tommy Vercetti, but... I think we need to be listening to V-Rock for this. It's a little silly to listen to anything else. So the issue is going to be not crashing. And they call it Brown... Again, anything else is called Vigilante missions. With the helicopter, they call it Brown Thunder as like a joke. It's a, you know, it's a poop joke, obviously. It's a reference to the film Blue Thunder, but changed to being a poop joke. Ha ha. It's a very Grand Theft Auto sense of humor. But the issue is not crashing. And I just did exactly what I told you guys never to do, which is try to steer using the control stick. So this, it's always a race. It's a race against time much more than anything else. Oh, boy. And a race not to crash. Oh, fuck. Okay, I'm making this look harder than it is. So I need to let him get a little bit ahead of me so that I can actually shoot him. Now let's see where this guy is. So Brown Thunder, it's... you have to get good at flying the helicopter, and you have to find open spaces to fight them, because when you're trying to duck and weave like I am between the street signs, I'm already off to a terrible start as far as not doing enough not damaging the helicopter so badly that it blows up before it's over. It's probably more resilient against bullets than other helicopters in the game are, but you still don't want to be fucking flying into shit. So, kind of not that happy with how this started, but you can move around a lot faster in this thing, flying over the city and flying over traffic, and certainly the cops are no threat to you. This one's all about not crashing while you're trying to fly around, and not running out of time because you're being so careful about not crashing that you're not actually getting after the crooks. So that's how it's done. As you can see, I got a wanted level already. It's possible that one star will go away before I get into... it's possible that one star will go away before I blow anything else up, but I'm not that worried. Oh, it already has. But the cops can do nothing to you in this thing. At six stars, I think other Apaches will show up, or Hunters as they're called. But who... I mean... they really can't do that much to you. Fuck. I am a little upset with myself there. Yeah, I should have gone to the machine guns earlier. Now I'm accidentally changing the channel on the radio. Okay, let's see where this next one is. I would love for them to stay on the main highway. It's, even though I did kind of a crap job with that guy, they're easier to fight on the main highways. Because you don't have to be as worried about them. Owner of a Lonely Heart's kind of a fun song to be playing while doing this, but... okay, now are you coming towards me, or... oh, you're going away from me. Excellent. That was a mistake, friend. You should have turned towards me to force me to turn again. Okay. All right, now I got a 2-star wanted level, so it's not going to go away on its own, but I was never going to get all the way through this thing without having a wanted level get over 2 stars. And as you can see, we're up to 2 vehicles. So this is where it gets really hard if you're trying to do it in a cop car. Or, I don't remember if this game has one. San Andreas has a police motorcycle, which is one way to do it because you're... Okay, I messed that up. Can we please switch the camera? Thank you. I'd like to be able to see where I'm going. Well, now I'm not sure what's going on. Yeah, I'm not sure exactly what's happening down there, and it's tough for me to... Let me pull back a bit. I think I've got a guy on... Oh, fuck. They generally can't do anything to you, but if I'm stuck being in one place for this long... I don't know where this guy has gone, but he's obviously on foot now. And I've taken a lot of damage here in my helicopter. Camera is not working with me well. Oh, he's got a new vehicle that he's in. Okay. I'm losing a lot of time here, but... Ah, fuck. So that's what it is. You either crash and get blown up, or you succeed brilliantly. So now let's see if... So I was about halfway through... And it's a whole different challenge from what it would normally be. You're just trying not to crash. You're trying to maneuver and point your nose to where you can fire at them without crashing while you're doing it. So, like, open areas are your friend. Anything else is your enemy. Now the moment of truth. Did my helicopter save? And it did not. I was afraid of that. Okay. So these missions are much easier with that helicopter. Like, I didn't do it, and I'm a little disappointed, but not shocked that I didn't do it on the first try. But it's much easier with that than it's going to be with the tank. So let's try it in the tank, and you'll see why that can be harder than it might seem like it would be. And the other thing is that I earned enough money there that, you know, I lost all my weapons. Maybe I should have just gone on from where I was wasted, because I did earn money from that. The frustrating thing is not having the helicopter anymore. And I'm pretty sure it's not because I loaded from the wrong slot either. I'm pretty sure I loaded from the right slot. But here's the tank. The tank is something I can save, so I'm really not interested in losing it. But it does not have radio. So it's less fun to be hanging around in for me, because you don't get to listen to the radio as you're creating all this chaos. You blow up vehicles just by touching them. And there's your problem. Now, you're going to get a wanted level really quickly, and as I mentioned, it's just as easy for the police to jack you out of this as it is any other car. And turning around is a big pain in the ass. And it also slows you down and gives them a great chance to capture you. Now, I might surprise myself and get this done. I think I got farther than level 6 or 7. Like, I was a little disappointed at how fast I lost... Yeah, see? Fucking, I'm trying to get some speed going. That was terrible. you're under arrest. He just grabs a tank and pulls you out of it, like, no trouble at all. So that's super annoying. I'll load this slot, but I'm pretty sure this is the wrong slot. I'll load this slot just to check and make sure that I definitely don't get to save the hunter. And if I do have it in this slot, great. But no, I don't. I didn't think I would. So let's instead load this proper slot, because I probably have slightly more weapons on it. I didn't expect to do that poorly with the tank, so I'm going to try it again with the tank before I just... I think I'm dedicated to just spending this particular video. We're about halfway through it already, geez. But I'm kind of dedicated now to spending it on... I guess I'm coming up here in case by some random chance the hunter came back. But let's try again with a rhino, and if that fails, I will go jack a hunter and try it again with a hunter. And if that fails, by then we'll probably have finished a video where I've shown you how these missions work and just how terrible a job I am capable of doing at them, apparently. Okay, so I got him. I need to be turning this way, I think. You want to go as long as possible without getting a wanted level and try as hard as possible to actually lose that wanted level. Oh, you son of a bitch. That's not going to save you. Now I got one star. And you see that little cop running around there? He's like the deadliest possible threat to me. Once you've given up on having a wanted level, you can try to just keep speed going. But eventually, like, even when you blow up the cars, they still have mass, and they will block your path and gradually slow you. So, like I said, it's very rare for you'd ever reach a point where this tank has taken enough damage that it's on fire and going to explode. You always lose, because eventually you get slowed down enough that some cop on foot just pulls you out and arrests you. Apparently that didn't quite hit this guy. Okay. Oh, he's on the overpass? I sure... It's not impossible for you to get rolled in a tank either. I've also failed that way. I found lots of ways to fail this. Let's say, I sure hope he's not heading for the other island. Because, sometimes long straightaways in these timed missions are good for you because they give you a decent amount of time, and it's navigating around traffic that eats you up and kills you, not the distance. So like taxi cabs and stuff, you usually kind of... Okay, so I got two wanted levels now, and I need to turn around. So turning around is always risky, because if there's a cop here, while I'm doing my three-point turn, I'm going to get arrested. I've been lucky with them spawning reasonably close to where I already am. Now I gotta turn around again. Okay, good. They're firing at me rather than just walking up to me. The key is to walk up to me, cops. It might be counterintuitive, but that's the key here. So this is, to me, I mean, other than the fact that with the hunter you actually get to listen to music, but this is what Grand Theft Auto is all about to me. Even if I don't succeed here, I mean, this is just what playing Grand Theft Auto was supposed to be. The problem is going to be, oh, that freaking taxi trying to come between those two guys. What a ridiculous moment. He's like, oh, I really don't want to stop for these guys. Oh, hold on, there's a tank also coming through the middle of traffic. And you have to be kind of aware of which types of obstacles are, yeah, and it's always kind of fun when they, see, this is the charred remains of a cop car almost overturned me. I don't know what that, was that like an undercover cop in that area? Yeah, I almost never manage to get the turret to help me. It's usually... I usually have to ram them with the tank itself. Once again, it's going to make me turn around. Although, hold on. I could... Three lefts equals... Oh, shit. Don't flip. Maybe I can do this in the tank. Well, I'm up to 4 stars wanted level. I think that's the most I've had on camera during this playthrough. At 5 stars, you start getting the FBI vehicles to show up, and the cops have... the FBI agents show up who just have... Like, I'm getting SWAT guys now. The FBI guys have more powerful guns and pretty fast-moving cars. But, again, nothing that a tank can't handle. The issue is at 6 stars... The army comes after you, and they also have tanks. And you just kind of need to stay away from them. There's no point in trying to take them out, because they're as resilient as you are. Again, your main thing is going to be now the cops are putting down spike strips. They might actually be less threatening than they are when they just treat you like a regular old motorist. And... Fuck, I got caught. I was trying to adjust the aim on the turret. Okay, I need to... I would say that I'm more of a threat right now than the guys I'm chasing. I don't know what kind of crimes they've committed, but plus 19 seconds, that's not enough time. Or 91 seconds, okay. Where's the new threat? Alright, I gotta get out of here. Oh no, I'm gonna get arrested. Oh, fuck. Oh, thank goodness they got dumb. They stopped trying to, okay, there's a guy who got the right idea. I need to get out of here. Hands on your head. I think once the guy's taken the tank, you stop worrying about taking him alive. Now, I could go looking for police bribes at this point. There's the FBI vehicles. Yeah, your issue is that these guys getting in front of you and blowing up just kills your momentum. Now I got like a regular cop, deadliest threat to me. Anything that stops your momentum is your real issue. Because you can run out of time chasing down the criminals. Those things are pretty resilient. They didn't get blown up by, Okay, I've lost track. I thought I knew where these criminals were, and I thought they were actually in range, but they're not. They're way over here. Probably need to just give up entirely on the turret. It's very rarely am I getting it to hit anything. I think it might even slow me down a little bit. There might be like a recoil on it. And I'm not clear on whether I can aim it up and down. Okay, good. That criminal didn't manage to escape because I was worried about that. You are... Oh, dead ahead. Perfect. And I got some momentum because the explosions have been pushing me in the right direction recently. So I'm certainly willing to lose this tank in exchange for... Okay, I gotta stop with the turret because it's slowing me down. Sure, it was useful there a couple of times, but I'm up to level 8. Okay, depending on the spawns, these guys I need to turn. I don't think I can use pay and spray in a tank. Pretty sure the game doesn't allow that. They have a message when you try to spray cop vehicles, and I think it counts as a cop vehicle. Fuck! No. Okay, thank you for shooting at me instead of trying to arrest me. That was close. And it's not impossible for you to take enough damage to be killed in the tank. It has a health meter. It's just much longer than a normal vehicle would be. And honestly, even if the tank gets destroyed, it's not over. It just means I would have to... Oh, thank you, guys. This is perfect. Thank you for turning in this direction. Okay. They're close by. I'm at level 10. What the? That's an invulnerable fence? I knew that telephone pole, ludicrously enough, was invulnerable, but I thought I could knock down that fence. That was almost a disaster. Let's get back to the main strip here. Because I think that's where they're going. The the criminals I'm after. Oh, please turn this way. Please come towards me. Yes. Perfect. Oh, how did that asshole survive? No. It's all going to hell. Come on, turn. No, please don't arrest me. I just don't need a regular cop. That's the one thing I really don't need right now. It's just a cop on foot who gets to be the hero and actually stop me here. I might actually be able to do this. I'm not saying I've never done it in a tank, but I remember specifically failing in a tank and doing it in the past using the Hunter. So doing it in the Rhino, which is like the classic way that people do it. I think most people find the Hunter difficult because of the fucking controls for the Hunter. And I'm doing good for time. That's often your problem if you're driving around slowly and deliberately avoiding a wanted level. Well, this guy definitely knows that I'm after him because he's driving like a maniac. Level 11, only two left. Okay, so I have to get back to the main strip here, it looks like. Okay. They are no longer on the main strip. I think I want to go the... Oh, freaking draw distance and this fence just appearing. Okay, guys, you're really being a problem right now. Because you're stopping me from getting where I need to go. Yeah, those are pretty resilient, those vehicles. Fuck. Got another thing that doesn't seem like it would be invulnerable, but is. Those little magazine racks apparently you can't destroy. We've got plenty of time. It's going to come down to whether I can get these guys without getting arrested. And I'm doing surprisingly a good job at keeping up with them speed-wise. Damn it, Director. I'm assuming they're driving legally and are on the correct side of the road, and I was right. Okay, this is the last one. If I get this, I've actually cleared it. So, don't screw this up. Now, where the hell are they? Okay, I basically just got to find a safe place to turn around. I've got lots of time. Lots of time. Just don't... Ooh, it seems like they're pretty close by. Don't get cute about trying... Well, no, I might be better off. Never mind, it's too late. I was thinking I could turn right and cut them off where they're heading, but instead I'll just straight up chase them. But this is where you could get in trouble. Cars, like the remnants of a car, blocking you so that you get slowed down enough that a cop can arrest you. Don't know what I got to do to get the army's attention at this point, since I don't already have it, and I've destroyed a lot of stuff. But the difference between 5 and 6 stars is pretty hard to get. Why is that guy still alive? Okay, I've split them into two groups. Okay, I think if I get this last fellow, who probably has jacked another car by now. Fuck, they're blowing up so much it's like throwing me off my path. That cop probably could have arrested me if he wasn't firing me with his gun instead, so thank goodness for a little small... relief. Yes! Body armor max increased to 150. So we've done it. Thing to do now is to try to get this vehicle back to home base. The vigilante missions will continue, as evidenced by the fact that there's a new target. But I don't care. I just need to try to get back to park. Those FBI vehicles are cool to have, but I mean, trading one for a tank? Actually, since I know how to get a new tank easily, it would make sense. Except that there's a real good chance I'd get killed while trying to jack it. You don't want to get killed while trying to jack it, folks. Love the fact that I was running over the Cubano gang members in my tank, and apparently they're still kicking. So good for them. And I can do a drive-by with my Uzi from my tank. Seems like it's not what you'd want to use your time in a tank to do, but it's available to you as an option. So this is nice, and. Between this and Pizza Boy missions, you can really substantially make the main story easier by giving yourself extra armor and health. I'm less worried about losing the tank now, because even if I lose it, we'll still keep this. But I would love to... I'd still like to get my tank back to home base and succeed at life. Here's the taxi place... I actually don't need to be navigating these back streets. I need to just get back to the main strip. I think there are back road paths that could get me to that save point, but I'll just cancel it. That will actually make it easier to see where I'm going, because I know I'm not going after those guys again. But we killed 82 criminals. We could have kept going. I really don't have any interest in seeing, like, what's the limit? How far can I go? We got a bunch of money out of it. I didn't notice what we started with, but we've certainly got more now. I'd have a lot more interest in seeing if I can actually retain the tank after all that. It's not a sure thing. It's entirely possible I get up to here And while trying to maneuver into my garage, I get killed or get shot while, you know, just trying to save. That would not be unheard of at this point either. Put my weapon down? My weapon is a tank. I'm pretty close now, aren't I? Yeah. Oh, this might be it, because that guy just got out of his... Oh, never mind. The guy, he's probably dead, the guy I was thinking of, because that cop car behind me blew up. It's like, I'm actually ready to end my rampage if you'll just let bygones be bygones and leave me alone.
Don't make me angry.
So there we go. We've got... We've increased our maximum armor. I now have a 5-star wanted level. Might be a tricky situation to get out of. But even if I can't, we still got a 5-star, or still got a new higher armor level. So that's pretty good progress. I really did want to do that on screen. I figured I would do it with the hunter. But as you saw, the problem with the hunter is totally different. You're going to get, if you're going to get blown up, it's going to be because you're bumping into stuff while trying to pilot the dang thing. But having gotten back and saved my tank just makes me feel pretty good. The only side missions... I guess somebody mentioned doing... roller derby, destruction, like car derby. I guess I'll look into that, because, yeah, I could do that in a Rhino. But it's not really... That's not what it's meant to be. It's supposed to be a regular car. But now that I've saved a Rhino, I could do it with a Rhino, and I could do it with a regular car. The other things that I need to show off on screen are ambulance missions, which I doubt I will get to level 12, and Pizza Boy missions, which that's pretty challenging too. And the deal with Pizza Boy missions is I wouldn't mind trying, just if I had free time and I wasn't, using all my time for record for the channel, I wouldn't mind. But like, A, it's tough to do Pizza Boy missions with an adult beverage in your hand, because it's actually pretty challenging to get all the way up to level 12. You have to really not lose any time at any point. So it's not something to do while you're, slowly reducing your reaction times with every sip. But if there was two I was going to succeed at on screen to make sure that I actually had, or even off screen, but if there's two that I definitely would want to get level 12, it would be Pizza Boy and Vigilante. We've already got one. So I think next time, if I can, after I lose my wanted level one way or another, Pizza Boy might be the next thing on the menu. See you then, guys.